dear friend, in the name of Jesus, it's always a pleasure to have you listening to the word of God, the great things that the word that the Lord is speaking to the church. And therefore, I take this opportunity to welcome you to walk through a journey together. We are looking at seasons. We are looking at seasons. And this is what we shall be looking at for the next few weeks. We will be doing some teachings on the various seasons that we go through as Christians. And I invite you, as we walk through this journey, I give you an invitation to always walk with us in the next few days so that the Lord will teach us about seasons. And at the end of the day, I promise you that you shall be a better Christian, more equipped, more strong to the glory and honor of the name of God in Jesus' name. Karibu sana. It's always a pleasure to have you. I celebrate you. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you. We give you glory. We worship you. We give you praise. You're worthy of praise. You're worthy of adoration. Thank you for giving us another opportunity, Father, to hear your word. We pray that you may speak that word that shall change us and make us and mold us and shape us in the name of the Lord Jesus. We need you. May you be with us in this evening service. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I gladly take this opportunity to welcome you to our midweek service. The Lord has been so gracious to me, and I continue to celebrate the goodness of the Lord. And I want to believe that the Lord has kept you well and strong as well. And we continue to bless the Lord. So, karibu sana, so that we can hear the word of God, so that we can share the word of God together. Genesis chapter 16. Genesis chapter 16, verse 1. The Bible states, "Now Sarai, Abram's wife, had borne him no children. And she had an Egyptian maidservant whose name was Agar. So Sarai said to Abram, 'See now, the Lord has restrained me from bearing children. Please go in to my maid. Perhaps I shall obtain children by her.' And Abram heeded the heeded the voice of Sarai. Then Sarai, Abraham's wife, took Agar, her maid, the Egyptian, and gave her to her husband Abraham to be his wife, after Abraham had dwelt 10 years in the land of Canaan. So he went in to Agar, and she conceived. And when she saw that she had conceived, her mistress became despised in her eyes." Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great evening that the Lord has given us. And we are doing a series on seasons. And particularly this evening, our focus is on the seasons of delay. Or in other words, we can say a season of delay. There are many seasons in the lives of people, and the Lord has organized life that things will be fulfilled in their time. Things will be fulfilled in their seasons. God has organized a number of things to happen in particular seasons in the life of a human being. He cannot allow everything to happen at a go, but he has scheduled different things to happen in different seasons in the life of someone. But in the process of waiting upon the Lord, we encounter the challenge of delay. And it's also a season. It's actually a season of delay. And this is what we would want. This is what we are focusing on this evening, all to God's glory and honor. So we have read a scripture from Genesis chapter 16. And we're seeing Sarai, who is Abraham's wife. And we can see after God called Abraham, of course, he gave him a promise. And in chapter 12 of Genesis, you find that from verse 1, The Bible says that when the Lord commanded Abraham to leave, he says, get out of your country, from your family, from your father's house, to the land that I will show you. Then he says, I will make you a great nation, I will bless you, and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him that curses you, and in you all families of the earth shall be blessed. So we see a great promise when the Lord was calling Abraham. But now, since he moved from his land, it was now 10 years, and still he had not had a child, he had not had a child of his own. And we see that Sarai really gets so much worried, and he tries to get a solution. Now, we see Sarai bringing a suggestion that Abraham could take the maid, and at the end of the day, this is what happened, and the maid conceived. So what we are seeing in this particular chapter is this woman, Sarai, trying to bring a solution. Why? Because the waiting was so long. They had waited for a number of years. And I think she was running out of patience. And I think, in my understanding, that she failed to understand that this was a season of delay that they had entered into. But the promise of the Lord still remained. But Sarai ran out of patience. And we are seeing now she tries to get a solution. And of course, at the end of the day, the solution never worked. Though, of course, they got a child. But you see, there were struggles here and there. But at the end of the day, of course, they were blessed with a child. But remember that this was not the child of the promise. That the promise of the Lord, the promise of God, was that I'll bless you, I'll make your name great, and you will be a father to nations. That was the promise of God. And now we see that Sarai has forgotten about the promise of God, and he is now pushing Abraham into something that probably he did not think about. Because Sarai was so much focused on getting a solution to the challenge that they had. Ladies and gentlemen, in this life that we are living today, it is not that things will be happening at any time, any moment that we hope and trust. Things may take time more than you think. Prayer may take more time to be answered, more than you think. Some troubles will stay longer than you expected. Some people will stay longer in your life than expected. Some problems will stay longer in your life than expected. That opportunity that you have been waiting for may take longer than expected. The peace that you're looking for may take longer than expected. And one of the greatest questions that Christians do ask all over is that why did God allow me to go through this? And then somebody again would say, you know, I have prayed, I have fasted, I have done this, yet things are not changing. I can tell you for sure, there are so many Christians that have given up on the way. Even when they prayed and they got convinced that indeed the Lord is answering their prayer. But the longer something takes, the longer the prayer takes, the longer this happening takes, at the end of the day, there is always a danger. But I've come to remind somebody that delay is not denial. It could be worrying, but the promise of God still stands. The promise of God still remains. Delay is not denial. And this is exactly what Sarai missed. Because she concentrated on sorting out a problem that she saw in her family, and she forgot about the promise of God of blessing them with children, of blessing them with a child. So therefore, ladies and gentlemen, it is important for you to know that things will not happen like pap, that every time you have prayed for something, it will come like pap, that every time you are waiting on something, that things will just happen like now. There are things that will delay in your life. And I can tell you, I know for sure, there are so many things, or there are so many seasons of delays that you have gotten into by the time you're getting to your age, by the time you're getting to where you are. I know you can indeed give a testimony of the seasons of delay. The things that delayed, there are things that could have delayed for years, others delayed for months, others delayed for days, and you continue to pray. And I can tell you, there are so many people that give up on the way. But I can tell you, life is not about getting everything the very moment you want it. Remember, our God is in heaven and our God is not like men. And therefore, the way things are scheduled to happen in life, the way things are scheduled to happen in life, they take that time all to God's glory and honor. So delay is not denial. And I would want to just make you understand what are the causes of delay, so that you don't have a need to worry when something has taken long, when a prayer has taken long before it is answered, when something has taken long, when the healing of the world is taking long, when things are happening in life, they are taking long to happen. That which you desire is taking long to happen. I would want us to walk through this journey together, all to the glory and honor of God. Causes of delay. What causes delay in your prayer? Delay of your vision. Delay of the things that you desire in life. What is that that causes delay in somebody's life? Number one, delay could be divine. Delay could be divine. Delay could be divine. Delay could be divine. What do I mean? Divine, I mean that some delays could be planned by God to serve some certain purpose in your life. Not the purpose of discouraging you, not the purpose of bringing you down, not the purpose of crushing you, but God could be wanting you to position you, to realign you, to repackage you, to energize you, to arrange a number of things so that now you are able to serve a certain purpose in life. So whenever there is a divine delay, God will always do it for reasons. God will always do it for reasons. And ladies and gentlemen, it is important for you to know this. That when Lazarus died, the sisters sent for Jesus to come. But the Bible says that he stayed 3 days more. He took 3 days more. He did not come immediately. He took 3 days more. And there was a delay. There was a delay. And the Bible says that Lazarus died. And you know, I know people could not understand why did Jesus take that long? Why did Jesus take that long? And yet Lazarus was his friend. It's because this delay was divinely orchestrated to serve some purpose that would bring glory and honor to God. So why would a divine delay take place in your life? Why would God want to delay some things in your life? Why would you encounter some divine delays in your life? Number one, it is so that God does it so that he can be glorified, so that he can be glorified in the end. Remember, the Lord is seeking for glory. Remember, the Lord is seeking for praises. And therefore, whenever there is a divine delay, it is to serve the purpose. It is to serve the purpose of bringing God glory, bringing glory to God at the end of the day. Number two, why would a divine delay take place? It is so that God can bless you in your waiting. So that God can bless you in your waiting. So that God can bless you in your waiting. In the case of Lazarus, you see that when Jesus finally came, the sisters were so happy. The sisters were so happy. And again, they felt now the assurance of the presence of Jesus. And you can see the miracle that followed. So it is not a matter of things happen the way you want. and the fast and with the speed that you so desire. You need to know that God may cause a delay so that he can bless you in your waiting. So that he can bless you in your waiting. I pray that for whatever thing that you are waiting for, may the Lord bless you in your waiting. In the name of Jesus. Whatever you are trusting God for, at the end of it all, I pray that it shall bring glory to God. In the name of Jesus. Number three, why would God allow divine delay? He allows divine delay because he is God and not man. He never works with the schedules of men. He is a king. He is a father. He is a great God. He is a mighty king. And therefore, because he is God, our thinking and his thinking are different, and we think on different levels. Actually, we cannot even compare. So he may cause divine delays as a revelation of who he is, as a revelation of who he is to us. So delays are divine. There are some delays that are divine. Cause number two, what is the cause of delay? What is the cause of a season of delay in your life? Sins may cause delays in our lives. Sins may push us into seasons of delay. Sins may push us into seasons of delay. And this we get from the children of Israel. From the children of Israel, when they were moving from Egypt, and the Bible says they go to Mount Horeb, and they stayed there for so long until God noticed. And he came and he said, you have stayed on this mountain for so long. Break the camp and advance. Break the camp and advance. Why? Because people on the way had started worshiping other gods. People on the way had started focusing on other things. And at the end of the day, they ended up taking longer than expected. So what does sin do? What does sin do when it is causing delay? You need to know that sin makes someone to concentrate on that which was not the focus of God. It makes you to focus on that which was not the focus of God. Number two, sin makes someone to focus on the present pleasure. Sin makes somebody to focus on the present pleasure. And in the present, in the process of focusing on this, in the presence, in the process of enjoying the present pleasure, you miss the purpose of God that is waiting for you. That is waiting for you. Number three, cause of a season of delay. Number three, cause of a season of delay. Number three, cause of a season of delay. A delay can also be demonic. A delay can also be demonic. A delay can also be demonic. Now you see, in the case of Daniel, the Bible says that Daniel fasted for 21 days. But remember, there was an engagement. There was an engagement between the angels, between the angel Michael and the prince of Persia. Why? It was a demonic, it was a struggle that Daniel has lifted a prayer to God. Daniel has made a prayer to God. But the demons have come to fight that which was about to happen. And in the process, there was a delay of the answer to the prayer of Daniel. So delays, the seasons of delay, could also be demonic. Seasons of delay could also be demonic. And why do demons would focus on our seasons of delay? Number one, it is to prevent the glory. It is to prevent glory at the end. Of course, the devil would not want God to be glorified at the end of it all. They would not want God to take all the glory. So the demons would want to fight your destiny. The demons would want to fight the seasons of your life so that there can be delays. So that at the end of the day, you are not able to bring glory to God at the end of everything. Number two, why would the demons focus on this? Just to frustrate. They would be focusing on frustration because they know that when a Christian is weighed down, prayer is a problem. They know that when a Christian is weighed down, there are so many things that never work. So they focus on frustration. And therefore you find that you are in a season of delay that is full of frustration.
a season of delay that kind of glory is completely absent. A season of delay where nothing is working, not moving forward, not moving backwards, but revolving around the same thing. Why? Because they focus on frustration. They focus on frustration. Number three, they focus on a season of delay because they would want to break you. Because they would want to break you. Because they would want to break you. Number three, number four, it's because they would want you to miss your destiny, which is the ultimate goal. Which is the ultimate goal. Which is the ultimate goal. So delays could be divine. Delays could be because of sins. Delays could be demonic. But I would want you to know that delay is not denial. The promise of God still stands. That which He spoke from the beginning shall be fulfilled in the fullness of time. In the fullness of time, in the name of Jesus. The Lord never changes. Whatever word He has released, whatever word He has spoken, whatever promise He has given, whatever thing that He has spoken concerning your life, concerning this nation, concerning our church, it shall indeed be fulfilled in the fullness of time, in the name of Jesus. If whatever you are going through, it is divine, I pray that in the name of Jesus, you're bouncing back stronger and richer. You're bouncing back wiser in the mighty name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So those are causes of delay. These are causes of delay in somebody's life. But I would want to bring to you now the facts. I would want to bring to you the facts about the seasons of delay. I would want to bring to you the facts about the seasons of delay. About the seasons of delay. Number one, fact number one, fact number one. A season of delay is a season of discovery. This is where I wanted us to get. The rest was just laying a foundation. A season of delay is a season. It is a moment of discovery. It is a moment of discovery. I am reminded about the four lepers who are seated at the entrance, of the city. And the Bible says that they stayed there. They stayed there. And one day they said, if we continue staying here, then we shall die. We shall die. But if we go to where we know that there is food, then if we die there, then we shall die. But if we are spared, then we shall live. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, never complain about the seasons of delay, because you're given an opportunity to discover and to rediscover yourself and to discover the capabilities of God in the name of Jesus. A season of delay is an opportunity to learn your weaknesses and to learn from them. In the seasons of delay, there is a lot of self-discovery that you know, ishida yenye niko nayo, ni mimi nimejiletea, imeendelea kukaa, sababu sijajua jinsi ya kuifukuza. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know this, that the seasons of delay is an opportunity for you to discover your weaknesses and to rediscover your weaknesses and learn from them, and learn from them. It is always also a defining moment of oneself. It is always also a defining moment of oneself. Ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you that the four lepers got to a point where they realized that the distance between them and food, the distance between them and food was not about kilometers. It was about discovery. It was about discovery. The earlier they discovered this, the earlier they could have sorted this. And we see the delays that they had in discovering this. Then at the end of the day, it happened later. So ladies and gentlemen, whenever you go through a season of delay, may it be divine, may it be because of sins, may it be demonic, it is an opportunity for you to take a journey of your life and see what the Lord has done in your life, what He is doing in your life, and what He will do in your life, all to His glory and honor. So we have said that it is an opportunity to learn your weaknesses and to learn your strengths in the name of Jesus. It is an opportunity for you to focus on prayer. It is an opportunity for you to strengthen your character. It is an opportunity for you to focus on your capabilities. It is an opportunity for you to build your relationship with God. It is an opportunity for you to discover the love of God. It is an opportunity for you to discover the love of God. So, ladies and gentlemen, are you going through a season of delay? Are you going through a season of delay? Do not complain about it. Do not let your heart to be broken, but instead rise to the occasion and take the opportunity to discover and to rediscover yourself in the name of Jesus. Because every season of delay, and I say it, may it be a divine delay, may it be a delay caused by sin, may it be a delay caused by demonic forces, whatever kind of a delay it is, never allow yourself to go down. Rise to the occasion and pick a lesson from that delay and discover the love of God. Discover the love of God in that season, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Actually, the season, every season of delay, it is always a season of assessment and reassessment. It is always a season of assessment and reassessment. It is kind of that your life has taken a pause. And now you can say, this is the far I have come. I have come with God. This is what I have done for the kingdom. This is not what I have not done. This is the far that I have come. These are things that I have not done. You can take a pause and assess your life and your relationship with the Lord. And if you have already done that, you reassess your progress. You reassess your progress so that you can be able to equip yourself for that which lies ahead of you in the name of Jesus. So celebrate every season of delay, because it is giving you an opportunity to discover yourself. And know this, that when you discover yourself and you build your relationship with God and you work on your weaknesses, it means that you have less chances of making a mistake ahead of you in the name of Jesus Christ. So therefore, ladies and gentlemen, every season of delay, it is not meant to crush you. It is not just meant to frustrate you. It is not meant to bring you down. Remember, at the end of the day, you will come out on the other end victorious, but you must be made, you must be shaped, you must be molded, all to the glory and honor of the name of God. Number two, every season of delay, it serves to reinforce our confidence in God. It serves to reinforce our confidence in God. It serves to reinforce our confidence in God. Jeremiah chapter 6 verse 16. Jeremiah chapter 6 verse 16. What does the Bible say? It says, thus says the Lord, stand by the roads and ask for the ancient paths where the good way is and walk in it, and find rest for your souls. But they said, we will not walk in it. First John chapter 5 verse 14. First John chapter 5 verse 14. The Bible states, this is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to remind you this, that every season of delay serves to deal with your fears and with your worries, to deal and to dispel the fears that you could be having about God. If you do not have a clear picture about what God can do, every season of delay gives you an opportunity to reinforce your confidence in God, to reinforce your confidence in God. And this is why Jeremiah 6:16 says, The man of God was speaking and says, stand by the roots and ask for the ancient paths. Ask for the ancient paths where you lost it, where the good way is, and walk in that ancient path. So a season of delay always takes you back to the right beginnings. It takes you back to the right beginnings. That if your faithfulness, that if your confidence in God was going down, a season of delay says, take a pause and build your confidence in Jesus. Build your confidence in Jesus. I like the confidence that Peter had when he was dealing with Jesus Christ. Peter is the man that dared God, that dared Jesus to do great things. Peter is the man that challenged Jesus on several areas. Ladies and gentlemen, every season of delay, it is not meant to do away with your life. It is not meant to write a bad story concerning your life. It is not meant to allow the demons to destroy you. It is for the purpose of reinforcing your confidence in God. So whatever kind of prayer that you have made and it has not been answered, do not give up. Reinforce your confidence in Jesus. Whatever thing you're praying for, wherever you are, and the prayer has not been answered, do not give up on God, because he's not giving up on you. Reinforce your confidence in God. Remember, the Bible says that he can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we think and even imagine. When the body tells you that this cannot work, remind it that the Lord said it in the name of Jesus. With that, you are able to dispel the fears and you live confidently in the presence of the Lord. And this is why 1 John chapter 5 verse 14, the Bible is reminding us that the confidence that we have in approaching God is that if we ask anything according to his will, anything, if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. If we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. This is the confidence that we have. This is the confidence that we have in God. John chapter 11 verse 21. John chapter 11 verse 21 and 22. What does the Bible say? It says, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. This is Sister Lazarus who is telling Jesus. When now Jesus came and found that Lazarus was already in the tomb for 3 days. And now the sister comes and says, Master, he is dead. And then he says, yes. If you had been here, see that confidence. If you had been here, my brother could not have died. But she never lost hope, because she says, even now that you're here, I know one thing. That whatever you ask of God, God will do it for you. See this.